appunto erano in terapia antibiotica, quindi vi faccio solo notare
why do we speak about infections and why so many people becoming
perché
involved in this? These are the Italian estimates in terms of cost, number of patients and so on. 450,000 to 700,000 a year with a cost of over 900 million euros a year. These infections, however, can be prevented. Maria Luisa Moro made an estimate and she says that about 1,300 people could be prevented from infections. To prevent infection, it's very important, therefore, to monitor the infection and to know one's reality. In our institute, we carry out an active form of monitoring. We carry out an incidence study of HAIs, and we've been doing so since 2003. And as of this year, we have started a prevalence study. As far as the incidence study is concerned, every patient who is admitted to a hospital has a specific card, which is filled out by the patient and tells us if they've had previous nosocomial infections and so on. We have 70% of patients with this kind of data. In January this year, we carried out a prevalence study. We went to the surgical departments on one specific day to see which patients were infected, and I will present the data of this monitoring activity. This is the percentage of our infected patients, between 5 and 8%, perhaps I'm underestimating a little bit. However, between 4 and 5% of the patients who come here to be treated incur an infection. Infections are those that we saw earlier on in the Italian study, pneumonia, catheter infections. 30% of our patients have a catheter, a surgical site infection, and blood infections. This is the length of the hospital stay. Whoever has an infection stays in the hospital longer. This is true in our facility as well as in others. Non-infected patients are in the blue, shown in the blue box. In orange, you can see the patients who have had an infection. And they, perhaps they're weaker, more severe patients who would stay longer. However, they have a hospital stay which is 6 times as long as those who do not have infection, constantly between 2003-2007. In the prevalence study, we went to see which patients were infected in the surgical wards. There were only 70 patients. However, 20% of these patients had been operated on in the 24 hours prior to the interview, and 27% had infections of the surgical site, pneumonia, or urinary tract. The number of patients undergoing an antibiotic therapy was 76%. What are the germs that are involved in these infections in our hospital? I have brought some examples to show you here. The surgical site, the most important germ is Staphylococcus aureus. We then have Enterococcus, Escherichia, Colipseudomonas, aeruginosa, and Candida. These are data that can be found in a number of studies worldwide. Blood infections, we said that our patients have catheters and they on which there are colonies of germs, especially those that we have on our Staphylococcus epidermis, which is regularly on our skin. And many of our patients have blood diseases due to gram-positive germs, especially Staphylococcus epidermis. Why is it important to have a good knowledge of one's own facility and to know which bacteria and which form of resistance there is? What does this mean? It means which antibiotics I can use and which I cannot use. to fight these infections. This is an American study in which the resistance of these germs was compared between 1998 and 2002. You can see the grey bars compared to resistance in 2003. And you can see that in 2003, resistance of these germs, Enterococcus, Staphylococcus aureus, Coccolase negative, Staphylococci. You see that the level of resistance changes in the course of time.
Quindi le resistenze cambiano nel tempo, in genere purtroppo aumentano.
A couple of examples. These are some of the main bacteria that are causes of infection, Staphylococcus aureus, the problem of which is that it is resistant to methicillin. When you see MRSA, it means methicillin resistant. And this is a resistance marker, which is very important, because if you have an MRSA, it means that the doctor has very few weapons to use, very few antibiotics. This is a germ, which is extremely pathogenic and causes very severe infections. The other problem regards the enterococci, which is vancomycin resistant, VRE. Here too, it is resistant to almost all antibiotics that are on the market today. We'll also speak about the gram negatives and the fungi.